Let us now move on to the second of the core functionalities of custom elements, which is defining and instantiating extended custom elements. I have set up this folder extended custom elements with an index.html, and this is the boilerplate code. For working with the extended custom elements, we still need to perform the 3 steps to register and 4 ways to instantiate the extended custom elements. Before we develop the code, let us head to the browser and then just observe the output what we are going to produce. Then we'll come back and discuss the code. So you could see that there is a button called OE button which exhibits some functionality, and also observe that this look and feel of this particular button is different from the standard HTML button. And whenever we do an instantiation of this extended custom element, it is going to create a button with this look and feel, and also with a message called OE button. And upon clicking that, it's going to give you this message. So this is what we are going to create as part of the extended custom elements demo. Now let us focus on this 3 steps to register first. We have already discussed all these 3 steps as part of the earlier demo on custom elements. Let us quickly run through this. So the first step would be to create a prototype that extends the native HTML element. So if you recall, we were using the HTML element as part of the previous demo, and we have taken the prototype and then we created a HTML element type of custom element there. But this time we are going to be more specific since we are developing a button element here. So the prototype is changing. So for the OE button proto, we are borrowing this prototype from the HT button element dot prototype. This is the step number one. Now the step number two would be to create a callback function with this created callback event. And so we are setting this inner HTML to be OE button. This is what is getting displayed here. And the styling and then the background color is being taken care here. Then in the third step, we require certain messages to be hooked onto this event handlers, because when we are actually clicking on this button, we would like some message to be displayed, and that's what is actually being configured here. And once all this is done, we need to perform the registration process. So as part of this step, where we are calling this register element with OE hyphen button, this is the name of the element, and then the prototype would be OE button proto, which we have developed over here. But also observe carefully that you need to add one more thing called extends it is button here. Since this is an extended custom element, so you need to specify that using this extends property here. Once all these configurations are done, you are using the inner HTML of the body in order to insert this particular code so that an instance of this particular button is getting created here. And also observe that this is where for a given button, you are getting this handle with the query selector, and to that on click event of this, you are actually wiring up this display message. So once this is done, the button will get rendered as part of the HTML page. So let us head to the browser and then check whether this is working. So this is the button that is rendered here, and then the functionality is working. Let us now also discover the other ways of providing this instantiation for this custom extended element. Notice that I have commented the earlier instantiation code. And now let us discover the first method of instantiating the extended custom elements. So we can declare this element using this style. So one is you are creating an instance of a button, and this is the message which is the attribute that this button is capable of taking. And along with that, you are specifying this is property here. Along with that, you are specifying the custom element name, so that a version of this particular button is getting created instead of the standard HTML button. So this is the simplest of all declarations. So let us save this code and then head to the browser. So you could observe that this markup has worked. So it is also displaying this particular message. So this is the first way of instantiating. Let us now look into the second method of instantiation. So this time we are going to make use of the OE button class here, which has been created at the time of registering the element, and we will create an instance of this OE button, and this button gets added to the body of the document using the append child method. So now we could observe the output in the browser. You could see that there are two instances of this OE button now, because we have used first two techniques of instantiate in the custom elements. Let us now discuss the third method. So the third method of element creation would be to use the element name instead of the class. So it ends up producing the same result. So let's just save this and then head to the browser. So you could see that the third instance of this button is added now. The fourth strategy would be to access the inner HTML and then initialize this. This exactly is the strategy we have used earlier in this demo to get an instance of this extended custom element.